opportunity to present and participate in this conference. And in my presentation, the agenda will be, I will just have a brief talk about Dubai Customs, vision, mission, and joint model, enterprise architecture journey in Dubai Customs, connected views, one of the EAP initiatives, enterprise capability management, and we end with the smart Dubai Customs smart transformation journey. Dubai Customs vision and mission is the leading to be a leading custom administration in the world, supporting the legitimate trade. And our mission actually, it is conflicting. It's about facilitating. When you facilitate, you need actually less inspection, while in the compliance, you have to do more inspection. So we have to strike the balance between the facilitation and the compliance. This model, actually, it presents Dubai Customs how we operate today. It consists of three main layers. One is the intelligence layer, the middle one is the trade facilitation, and the compliance domain. All layers are automated by enterprise architecture team and the IT department. Briefly, we receive Dubai Customs like any other customs administration. They receive information from many resources. One of them is the customs officers or from the police or from the other agency. We have a risk engine. We take this information and we create a profile against any declaration. If you want to transact with Dubai Customs, you have to submit a declaration, a document. They call it a customs declaration. And before we clear it, actually, we match the information that is available in the declaration with the risk engine. If there is no any risk, it will be cleared. And in case if there is any risk information, the declaration will be transferred to the inspection or investigation to any other or any other domain. Enterprise architecture, actually, this is the background. A few years back, enterprise information was scattered, unorganized, and not available uniformly in a single repository. So there was no proper alignment between the organization's strategic objectives, policy, process, and services, and technology. That was actually a few years back. The objective was we have to establish a large information portal that includes all the organization information, which will support the top management and the employee, the decision making. So the vision was for the enterprise architecture team was to have a single source of the tool of planning, decision making, and impact analysis by assessing the effectiveness of the proposed changes. So enterprise architecture, as a result, enterprise architecture was introduced in Dubai Customs and actually helped Dubai Customs building one of their initiatives, Enterprise Connected View, which we'll see here. As can be seen here, Enterprise Connected View, it's one of the Dubai Customs enterprise architecture team achievement. It's actually connect the organization. It's provide a holistic view all the organization information, starting from the strategy layer, then to the business layer, information, and then the technology. So in Dubai Customs, actually, business is clients, IT, everything goes through the enterprise architecture. Enterprise Connected View represents a blueprint of the organization, as I said, and it links the business layer, which consists of the services, department, initiatives, policy, processes. It links it to the information and the technology. So now in Dubai Customs, you can actually view all the organizational information. You can do a proper impact analysis. You can do a proper change management because all the organization information is documented and architected by the enterprise architecture team, starting from the strategy till the business and the technology components. This is just snapshots from the enterprise architecture repository in Dubai Customs. As can be seen here, the service component architecture. Here is an example of the process architecture, end-to-end declaration process. Process diagram, the detailed process architecture diagram, which consists of the activities, tasks, and input and output. All Dubai Customs job description and all also is already linked to the process architecture and service architecture. So any employee can just browse the enterprise architecture roster and he will be able to see his job description associated with his roles and responsibility in terms of the process service in details. And here is the example of the technology architecture artifacts. Also, enterprise architecture team was able to actually disseminate all the information in enterprise architecture repository and enterprise connected view through all smart devices to all customs employees. So they are now able to use the smart their smart devices and browse all the information that they need in the day-to-day operation or to the top management in case if there was a decision or impact analysis. Also, here is a sample of the enterprise architecture impact analysis tool. We built the enterprise, we call it Discover tool, on the top of the enterprise architecture connected view, repository. And now you are able to just, if you want, just write the any keyword like the service name, the process name, the system name, and just press search, you will find. And you will get a complete, comprehensive report, the impacted area in the organization in terms of process, people, information, policy, department, roles, responsibility. You will be able to find all this information with less than 1 minute. So the top management and the leader, before now in Dubai Customs, before they take any decision, they go to the dashboard and check the impact of the change before they take any decision. And this is the actually the value of having the enterprise architecture team, which consists of the business architect and technology architect. Here is also the end-to-end declaration process architecture in Dubai Customs. Also, we use the process architecture simulation in order to simulate the result before we get approval in the process improvement. So in summary, what are the benefits of enterprise architecture is improved alignment. And here is the alignment between the business and the technology. That is the more important alignment. Enhance the decision making. If you have a holistic view of all the organization information, if you link the strategic objectives with the process, with the people, with the technology, and with the information, you will be able to take a right decision. Here is the key word, a right decision. We provide all the architectural information for the organization, but also we connect it. So we are providing the organization a connected information. It will also reduce the delivery time and enhance the corporate governance. Also highlight the area of improvement. Here, due to the great EA success that we have made at Dubai Customs, the organization realized cost-saving opportunity in excess of $200 million and improved its service delivery by 75% at Dubai Customs. Now I'm going to talk about another initiative Enterprise Architecture is doing. We actually working jointly in Enterprise Capability Management. What is the capability? Capability is what the organization needs in order to deliver its services and execute its business objectives and goals. So enterprise capability is enables that the organization enables that the organization needs to perform its function to achieve its objective, and the main and the most important objective of having the capability management is to develop the enterprise capability to explore the future fund to do the proper prioritization for the projects and the initiatives. So you need to have the enterprise capability to measure the maturity of the capability of the organization and focus on the areas for the improvement. Enterprise, as per the enterprise architecture team, we have three levels of the capability. First level is the executive or the top management level. Second level is the customer focused, and the third one is the support level. In the executive focus level number one, which determines the organization and the strategic decision for the organization from the top management point of view. The customer focused area capability is actually perform the key task and work which include what business does the organization offer, that is from the customer point of view. And the back-end focus or the support capability that support the top management and the customer capability in the organization. The enterprise capability initiative journey in Dubai Customs, actually, we started with this initiative in 2012. The assessment was manually, actually, and the assessment was also through the interviews. You go, you take an appointment with the business, you go to the meeting, and you start asking the business owners who own the capabilities some questions which are related to the four main components: people, process, technology, information. So the capability, it's actually consists of the people, technology, information. The approach was actually interviews. Now the approach which we are adopting starting from 2016 is through the self-assessment on a smart device. You can have access and you can actually assess your capability as a business owner. Outcome. Previously there was assessment report. Currently the outcome is helping the project delivery team in order to prioritize the most important capabilities that the business needs to focus on. The enterprise capability management process consists of the four main processes. The first process is identify and describe the capability of the organization, and we have completed this first process. Second one is to build the capability map, which we just saw, and which consists of the three main levels: the strategic, top management, and then the customer. The third level was the support. The third step in the capability assessment is to assess the capability. As I said, the capability assessment is available through the smart device. And we have complete 98% across the organization. The fourth step will be improve the capability and optimization of the capability based on the assessment model. This is just walking through the smart capability assessment for the organization. So enterprise capability assessment objective, a new technique to lead the investment decision, a fact-based method to determine where to exactly invest and which projects, a high-level assessment for the organization's capabilities. And the assessment will be the responsibility of the manager, I mean the head of section, and the director of the department. So every function, in the manager side, they have to assess the capability, they have to review the result, and they have to review the capability map of their section and then rate and assess. When the head of section done his assessment, the director of the same department will review the result and the assessment of the manager, and then he will set the importance. He will set the importance to the project team and to the enterprise architecture team, saying that this area is the most important area which I need to have a project for it. And then he will set the desired maturity level that he thinks that he wants to reach. And then he will review the capability map and submit the final outcome. Here is part of the assessment. And the assessment covers people, process, technology, information. There are some questions in each dimension. And based on that, we get the final outcome. Here is samples from the final result. Prioritization. Also, the heat map of the department. The Otkala means we need to work in this area, software more improvement. Also here is the prioritization based on the result of the assessment. The project delivery team and the was official reprioritize the project roadmap of the organization. Now we will cover some part of the transformation, Dubai Customs transformation. Transformation of Dubai Customs was inspired by the vision of the his famous Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid. He is UAE, United Arab Emirates Prime Minister and owner of Dubai. Dubai is one of the United Arab Emirates city. So for Sheikh Mohammed, he said, the smart government does not sleep. Quick in processing its interactions, works 24 hours a day, 35 days a year, is the life of the people through the smartphone. And that was actually our basis in transformation at Dubai Customs. Our goals was to be the first government department in United Arab Emirates to deliver his Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid vision towards the smart government transformation. Objective to become a number one in 100 days. Provide 100% of the client, 100% of the client services online through the smart devices. We used to be electronic, but as we are the vision of Sheikh Mohammed, we have to have all services enabled smart through a smart device. So we have to achieve at least 79% of the customer satisfaction or happiness. What we have done actually in Dubai Customs in order to achieve the Highness Sheikh Mohammed vision, we actually innovate a model. We innovate a model to frame our transformation efforts, which covers, as you see here, our smart transformation model covers people, process, technology, information, and is enabled by many business and technical practices area. Like one of them, as can be seen, is the enterprise architecture and the business process, demand management, project delivery, and the IT department, solution delivery, and the that was the our actually mission and model for to achieve the transformation. The goal was the smart device to delight the customer and increase the trust, client engagement, noise, electronic adoption, a smart solution to enhance the employee productivity and happiness, innovate and optimize Dubai Customs operating model. And this is our actually service excellence methodology. So any projects or any initiatives should actually comply to this framework, which enterprise architecture and the innovation management is part of it across the life cycle of the project, which is starting from the initiation up to the sustainability and the implementation. It consists of many and international practice area that is some of them related to the business area and the other part technology. So the smart government journey in Dubai Customs, in 2009, Dubai Customs was the first government department with 100% service enabled to all electronic channel. In 2005, Dubai Customs achieved Sheikh Mohammed vision as a first government department with 100% service to be a smart enabled. In 2016, we have achieved the first government department within Dubai with the highest customer happiness. Customer happiness indicator is managed by Dubai Smart Government Office, which is part of the Dubai Executive Council. And as per the 2016 report, we are the first government department within Dubai with the highest customer satisfaction and happiness. It is more than 96%. Here is the result of the smart transformation journey, and it is updated up to January 2017. In line with Dubai smart strategy, Dubai Custom has introduced multiple smart channels to increase the electronic adoption to 97% and the smart adoption to 30% in 2016. And you can see here the Dubai Customs channels. We have business to government channel, smart home space channel, file upload, auto declare, mobile, smartwatch, and we are working currently in the blockchain channel and the customs to customs in a single window channels. Recognition and awards, we have two international recognition. One of them is from the World Customs Organization. In their Columbus report, they have mentioned that Dubai Customs has an impressive range of the IT systems, which can be rightly regarded as a world class in which other custom administration around the world could learn from. And that report is already published in the WCO website. But in the World Economic Forum, as per the competitiveness, World Economic Competitiveness report in 2016, Dubai Customs is the first customs administration in the GCC and ranked fourth globally in that indicator in the efficiency of the custom procedure and services. Here we have many awards we received, mainly for the enterprise architecture capability management, from Design Platform Award, Open Group, Global Innovation Institute, UK Ideas, First Town, and First Answer. Thank you very much.